Hi guys, it's Mrs. Hutchinson. Today in Reader's Workshop, we're actually going to do some social studies work. Today we are going to be talking about consumers and producers. So I'm going to stick with you on this one, and we're going to read through some things together. So we're going to click here first. All right, we have this paper here that says consumers and producers. All right, so let's look at this lady right here. She looks like she is buying something in a market and they're exchanging money. So if she's buying something, she is a consumer. So let's read it. You can use money to buy things. People work to earn money to buy things they need or want. Consumers are people who buy goods and services. Goods are things that are made for people to use. Books, food, toys, and clothes are all goods. Now, if you remember, one way I told you to remember what a good is you can hold it in your hand. Remember, like, you can hold a football in your hand, you can hold a book in your hand. Those are goods, okay? Now, a service, you see this man over here, he's pushing the lawnmower. A service is work or a duty that someone does for another person. If your parents pay someone to mow the lawn or wash the car, that is a service. So you can provide a service or someone else can provide a service for you. Okay, goods and services. Alrighty, let's scroll down. Okay, so here we have someone that is working, and it says, some things we need and want are made by people. People who make things for other people to buy are called producers. So he is producing an item for someone else to buy. What are other ways to get things we want? Oh, do you see this family here? What are they doing? Like they're starting. Oh no, they've already started their garden. They're harvesting. What are those? Potatoes. Oh my goodness. Some families grow crops on a farm. They take what they need from the crop, excuse me, for their families to eat. The extra is taken to a market, sell, or trade. They trade or exchange the extra crops for money or other goods they need. Look at all of the food. The farms make, I'm sorry, farms reduce the food that we all get to buy. Long ago, people had milk delivered to their homes. They paid for the milk, the goods, and for the delivery, the service. The trucks were small and were filled with blocks of ice. Today, technology has changed the way the milk is delivered. Large special trucks keep the milk cool and fresh. It is then packaged and delivered to stores. Oh my goodness. So we have a really small truck. And now today, we have these huge trucks. Amazing. Things really change over time, okay? Okay, so let's go back. So we read to the article, Consumers. I'm sorry, we read the article, Consumers and Producers. Then we're going to visit this website, Pebble Go, and we're going to learn more about consumers and producers. Password. Right. This is really cool. Now, I could stay with you, but I think I'm going to let you go on this one because you can do this one by yourself. So what you can do, click this speaker button right here.
People buy and sell goods and services every day.
Okay, so you can have it read it to you. There's also a video that you can watch. So this is talking about people who buy or use things that are called consumers. So the video that's attached is going to show you what a consumer looks like. This is just one way that someone can be a consumer. But if your mom or dad ever go to the grocery store and they buy their produce there, they are a consumer. So we go back, and then we've got
producing goods.
Producing goods, another video.
Producing services. Consuming goods. Consuming services.
And then we got a read more section if you want to go ahead and study up some more on this. Really, really cool. So I want you to think about what are some ways that you might be a consumer. How are you a producer? Do you ever produce goods or services? Think about that. Talk with your family about it. I bet you guys can come up with some really cool ideas on how you can be a consumer and a producer. All right. After you are done with your social studies, please spend some time reading independently for at least 20 minutes. I can't wait to see you, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Bye.